With racing season fastly approaching, I'd like to inform new fans about NASCAR. With the rising growth of this sport internationally as of late, I'll be going over the cars, the support classes, the schedule, the point system, and much more here in the Beginner's Guide to NASCAR. NASCAR, or the National Association for Stock Car Auto Racing, based out of Daytona Beach, Florida, is a privately owned company that was founded in 1948 by Bill France Sr. Currently, the premier series in NASCAR is the NASCAR Cup Series, which is what I'll be focusing on mainly here today. But I'll also be covering the companion series, such as the NASCAR Xfinity Series, the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series, and the ARCA Menard series. I first off want to talk about the NASCAR Companion Series. These are development series for younger drivers to showcase their talents and progress to the ultimate goal of racing in the Cup Series. The natural progression starts with the ARCA Menard series, then the Craftsman Truck Series, then the NASCAR Xfinity Series, all to the ultimate goal of racing in the NASCAR Cup Series. Although this isn't a linear path, as we've seen in recent years, drivers skip past respective series. The ARCA Menard series has a national series, which races at a variety of tracks, while also having regional series, such as the ARCA West and the ARCA East. The ARCA Menard series has been a diverse series throughout the years, being now a developmental series and formerly a poor man's cup series, per se. Now that I've briefly discussed the companion series, I'd like to talk about the Cup Series car. In 2022, NASCAR debuted the next-gen car, or the Gen 7 car, in the Cup Series. Taking many leaps in advancement, specifically in aerodynamics with redesigned step splitter, side skirts, hood vents, and most importantly, a rear diffuser to change air effects on the rear of the car. Taking inspiration from many different racing series around the world. The next-gen car also has implemented use of single-source parts, such as a chassis partnership with Dallara to help reduce team costs. It also uses advancements such as sequential gearboxes, independent rear suspension, and larger, lighter, single-lug wheels. The manufacturers that will be represented in the 2024 NASCAR season include Toyota, Ford, and Chevrolet. Now that I've discussed the car, it's time to explain the schedule, race format, and season format. The 2024 schedule includes a total of 36 full points-paying races, as well as several non-point exhibition races and qualifying races. The season kicks off with the Clash, which is an exhibition preseason-type race, before moving on to the biggest race of the season, the Daytona 500. The Great American Race, the Daytona 500, is the biggest race of the season and is the first official points-paying race. The five-day event starts with qualifying on Wednesday and dual races on Thursday to set the 40-car field for race day on Sunday. The winner of this race claims the championship of this event. This is the first of four crown jewel events on the NASCAR schedule, with the World 600 at Charlotte, which is the longest race on the schedule. Also, the Brickyard 400 at Indianapolis, which makes its return here in 2024. And also, the Southern 500 at Darlington, which is the toughest track on the schedule. The next premier event on the schedule is the All-Star Race, which is a non-point exhibition race showcasing the best drivers, teams, and pit crews each season, with $1 million payout on the line. This event has seen many formats and tracks throughout the years. This season, however, the event will be held at North Wilkesboro for a second straight season. The NASCAR schedule consists of a variety of tracks, from short tracks or short ovals, speedways or intermediate ovals, and super speedways such as Daytona and Talladega. It also includes several road course races each year, as well as the introduction last season of street course racing, which we had the inaugural event last year at Chicago. Before I explain the season format, I want to explain charters. These are the equivalent of automatic entry into every race throughout the season. NASCAR currently has 36 charters, which are held by teams. The charter is represented by a car on track. The NASCAR championship is contested by these 36 cars and drivers each season. You can compete without a charter in NASCAR, but at a disadvantage to those with charters, who have locked in grid spots and increased revenue. Now that you have an understanding of the car, schedule, and who competes, I will simplify the season format the best I can. The NASCAR regular season consists of 26 points paying races. Drivers compete to compile points on a race-by-race basis to qualify for the NASCAR playoffs. The top 16 point-earning drivers lock themselves into the playoffs after the 26th race. Although, if you win a race during the regular season, you are granted a playoff spot. The NASCAR playoff consists of 10 races and 4 rounds. The first 3 rounds are 3 race mini-seasons. Points are reset at the beginning of the playoffs and each round for those still eligible for the championship. After each of the first 3 rounds, the bottom 4 in points are eliminated. Now the fourth and final round is a one race winner takes the championship event. The top 4 drivers remaining compete for the title, where the highest finishing driver of the 4 at the season finale at Phoenix claims the championship. I have a very detailed point system video, and I'll leave that link in the description of this video for you to easily understand the complicated points system. I would like to explain the race format. Each race is divided into 3 stages, with the exception of the World 600, which has 4 stages. After each stage, points are awarded. The first 2 stages, points are awarded to only the top 10 drivers, respectively. The end of the race, which is the final stage, points are awarded to the entire field. At the end of a stage, the caution is thrown, allowing teams to make a pit stop or stay out on track according to the strategy they have implemented. This is a short break to reset the field for another restart. NASCAR also tries to end each race under green. With the implementation of overtime, this is a 2-lap shootout or green-white checkered finish. NASCAR allows for an unlimited amount of attempts to get a green finish. Although, once the white flag is displayed, the race becomes official if a caution was to happen. Now that we have established the support series, the Cup Series car, the schedule, the crown jewel events, the charter system, and race formats, you are now off to a basic start with NASCAR. With the growing popularity of NASCAR racing across the globe, my goal was to educate you before the start of the upcoming season. I hope you now better understand NASCAR. If there's anything I may have missed or something you would like to better understand, leave those responses in the comment section below. Thanks for watching this video and make sure to like and subscribe to see more great content like this. Now go out and enjoy the amazing, thrilling, and exciting racing that NASCAR has to offer.